Hello viewers, welcome to another video. In this video, I will be explaining what is resistance and what is reactance. Afterwards, I will explain two different types of reactances. The first one is the inductive reactance and the second one is the capacitive reactance. So let's start with the definition of the resistance. The resistance is a measure of the opposition to the flow of AC and DC current in an electrical circuit. Here you can see a complete circuit in which there is a power source and the resistors are connected in series and parallel configuration to the power source. So how a resistor offers resistance to the flow of electric current? Let's see here. So every conductor offers the resistance to the flow of electric current based on its intrinsic property, which is the resistivity. The formula of the resistivity is rho L over A. Here we can see that the resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor and inversely proportional to the area of the conductor. So if we say that the cross-sectional area of the conductor reduces, the resistance increases. Similarly, if the length of that increases, the resistance increases. Here we can see the graph of voltage and current when the current flows through a resistor. You can see here the voltage and the current are completely in phase with each other, that there is no phase difference, and the formula of the resistance is governed by the Ohm law, which is R equal to V over I. So you can compute the value of the resistance if you have the value of the voltage and the current. So let's see what is reactance. A reactance is the opposition to the flow of only AC current caused by the inductors and capacitors. Here you can see a complete electrical circuit in which there is an inductor and the capacitor connected in series with the AC power source. So the opposition that is offered by these two components to the flow of electric current is called the reactance. Now we will see there are two types of reactances. The first is the inductive reactance. So the inductive reactance is symbolized by XL, and the formula of inductive reactance XL is equal to 2 pi FL, where F is the frequency and L is the inductance. On my right side, you can see the graph between the reactance and the frequency. Here you can see as the frequency increases, the inductive reactance also increases. So it means that at higher frequency, the inductor offers more opposition to the flow of electric current. Now let's try to understand how an inductor offers opposition to the flow of electric current. So basically, an inductor is a coil of wire. So whenever the AC current flows through this inductor, it generates a magnetic field around it. So this changing magnetic field induces a voltage in this coil, which opposes the flow of current through this coil. So this is how an inductor offers a reactance or the opposition to a flow of AC current, and this is called inductive reactance. Now let's see the voltage and current graph of an inductor. Here you can see the blue line is the voltage curve and the dotted red line is the current curve. You can see here that the current lags the voltage by some angle because inductor offers opposition to the flow of electric current through it, just because of the reason I have told you earlier. Now let's see what is capacitive reactance. So the capacitive reactance is symbolized by XC, and the formula of XC is 1 over 2 pi FC. Here you can see that the capacitive reactance is inversely proportional to the frequency and the capacitance. On the graph you can see that as the frequency increases, the capacitive reactance decreases. It means that at higher frequency, it offers less reactance to the flow of electric current. Now we can see the voltage and current graph of a capacitor. Here you can see that the red dotted line, which represents the current, leads the voltage by some angle. So we have seen here that in inductor and capacitor, there is a phase difference between voltage and current, while in the resistance, there is no phase difference between voltage and current. So how the capacitor offers opposition to the flow of electric current in the form of capacitive reactance? Let's try to understand. Here you can see there are two plates of the capacitor. Between them is the dielectric. So at low frequency, the capacitor has more time to charge and discharge. It means that less current will flow and there is more opposition to the flow of electric current. But at higher frequency, the voltage changes so quickly that the capacitor can never be charged or discharged fully. So more current will flow and less opposition to the flow of electric current is offered by the capacitor at higher frequency. So this is called the capacitive reactance. I hope you clearly understand the concept of resistance and reactance. For more interesting videos, stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe our channel. Thank you for watching.